Welcome back to Get Down to Business, the show all about small business, jobs, and entrepreneurship. You can always get on my website, shalomklein.com, or you can get on your favorite podcast apps where you can subscribe, rate, review, and share. Super easy so you never miss a single episode. So I'd say in my 10 plus years of doing this show, I've only had a handful of folks that I've brought on more than once. And that's been intentional because I'm always trying to overload you with lots of knowledge, information, resources. And that's exactly why I'm bringing my next guest back on. You heard from her just a few weeks ago, but it's Patricia Mota. She is the CEO of the Chicago-based nonprofit, the Hispanic Alliance for Career Enhancement, HACE. For over 40 years, HACE has been committed to the Latinx community, specifically dedicated to the employment, development, and advancement of current and aspiring Latino professionals. You heard her passion just a couple of weeks ago on the program. But Patricia, welcome back to Get Down to Business.
Thanks for having me back. Glad to be here.
Absolutely. I know you're getting ready for your annual National Leadership Summit and Celebration, April 20th through 21st. For all of our listeners, never fear, because we're going to make sure that we share a lot about that upcoming event in just a few minutes. But please tell us about the creation of your very important organization's mission.
Absolutely. Yeah. The organization was founded in 1982, so 41 years old, national in scope. And the mission then continues to be the mission we uphold today, which is to positively impact workplaces by cultivating the pipeline of Latinx, Latine talent, and providing the community the insight, access, and support to be successful in their careers. And we carry this mission, we deliver on this mission through three core areas. While we have been around since 1982, how we deliver on the mission, as you may imagine, has evolved over time. And today it's through one, talent acquisition. So these are programs and services where we're actively connecting job seekers, anywhere from interns to senior level talent to our employer partners. We've got about 200 corporate partners across the nation that we work with to help connect with this talent pool. Two is what we consider our pipeline and leadership development program. So these are cohort model trainings that could be anywhere from a few months to year long that include individual coaching, culturally relevant content, and most importantly, a strong support network across the nation. Awesome. Where we have folks more senior in their careers coming back and giving as speakers, subject matter experts, mentors, and those in their careers doing that for our students.
And that's awesome. And how do you get involved?
Yeah. And the last area is around thought leadership. And this is the best practices in helping employers get involved. I got involved in 2010 as a program director at the time. I had earned my graduate degree and was looking for an organization that could build and scale programs. And that's where it really became our core focus. My first project was Mujeres de Ace for Latinas, helping them advance and help close the pay gap and wealth gap that they experience. And now since we have a whole array of leadership development programs and offerings.
Again, I'm chatting with Patricia Mota, the CEO of a very, very amazing organization, HAC, as you've just been hearing Patricia's passion about the important work that they're doing in the Latinx community. It's incredible. And I know that you are having an upcoming national summit and celebration, April 20th through 21st. So first of all, are tickets still available? And tell us a little bit about that. What's going to happen during those 2 days?
This is the second time we're doing hybrid, meaning that we have both in-person and virtual opportunities to engage. This is two full days of professional leadership development workshops for those that are seeking for tools and resources to get promoted in their career, to become more visible. And those in talent acquisition or DEI roles that are looking for best practices and how to best connect with talent and what they can do internally and externally to help support the advancement of not only Latino, but diverse talent that's underrepresented within their companies and organizations.
That's awesome. And I know you are, again, the advocate around DEI, which is just awesome. So let's talk about that. Let's talk about diversity for a moment. What are some of the issues, Patricia, that that Latinx professionals are facing today?
Yeah, absolutely. And I myself, being first-generation college graduate, Latina, Mexican-American, daughter of immigrants here in the U.S., have personally faced a lot of the challenges firsthand, whether it's through education, lack of access and resources. But then as I got into my professional career, not seeing myself represented in leadership roles. Across, let's say, corporate America, 4% of senior-level roles are held by Latinos and 1% Latinas. And if you look at the demographics and the landscape, we are currently about 20% of the US population. But we also represent economic contributions, contributing at a 2.84 trillion GDP, meaning if we were a country, US Hispanic Latinos would be the fifth largest GDP. And so not only is it the right thing to do in terms of representation, but it's an economic and a business imperative for organizations to ensure that they're hiring, retaining, advancing Latino and diverse talent.
Wow, that's incredible knowledge and information. And I want to dive just a drop deeper before we have to cut into break. What are some companies that you're seeing? What are they doing in terms of DEI practices and talent acquisition, sort of accelerate and amplify the investment, hiring, and retention efforts for diverse talent and promoting those folks into leadership roles?
Yeah, they understand the need for culturally relevant programming. They're investing in our Mujeres de ACE, in our advanced leadership program, and having their talent go through that so that they know what is it that the tools, the resources, and the executive support that's needed for them to advance in their career. At Antenna, we're working with these corporations to be able to support them with the resources, tools, best practices, so that internally they're setting up equitable practices so that they are hiring, advancing talent throughout the organization as well.
Awesome. Well, again, I'm chatting with Patricia Mota, she and her amazing organization, they're having an awesome, awesome celebration April 20th through 21st that you certainly don't want to miss. And we'll definitely make sure that we link to the important work at the Hispanic Alliance for Career Enhancement in just a moment. But a very quick break, and we're going to continue our conversation with Patricia in just a moment. So don't touch that dial. Welcome back to Get That Business, the show all about small business, jobs, and entrepreneurship. I am chatting with an innovative trailblazer, startup entrepreneur, connector, public speaker, and compassionate leader who is the CEO, president and CEO of the Hispanic Alliance of Career Enhancement, HACE for short. We've just been chatting about some really, really important topics relating to diversity, equity, and inclusion, and hearing a little bit about Patricia's story, which is truly very, very inspiring. So, inspiring is what you do, Patricia, and I know that you are paving the future for HACE and for Latinx individuals and for other diverse populations that want to work in executive leadership roles. So what are some of the things, Patricia, that you see in the future of the organization, and how are you getting there?
Absolutely. Well, one is to recognize and to celebrate. As you mentioned, we're celebrating our National Leadership Summit, but it's also a milestone in for our Latina Leadership Program, Mujeres de ACE. It's the 15th anniversary. And so we're doing a special brunch celebration during the summit. And we're calling it a quinceañera, which is culturally relevant because when a young woman turns 15, we do a big quinceañera in Latino culture. And then our annual awards gala, which is the evening of Friday, April 21st. And so as we recognize and celebrate where we've come, as we look in the future, we're really honing in on accelerating equity with action and accountability. That's our theme for the year, meaning doubling down on best practices, things that are working, but also innovating and trying new things that really help us not only close the gap, but accelerate the time that has been lost for folks that perhaps are under have been undervalued in their organizations.
Awesome. Awesome. So when a young man or woman comes to HACE, again, whether a student in high school or college, a professional in transition, whatever the case may be, and they come to you and your team, I know you've got a lot of programs. You've already alluded to it earlier in our conversation. What does that process look like? What are some of the tools that you have in your toolbox to be able to take care of them?
Yeah, our youngest demographic is high school and college students that we work with, and they get to participate through our programs, which are career development, access to visible Latino role models, right? Many of them being either first generation thinking about college or thinking about trades or thinking about opening an entrepreneur, being an entrepreneurship. They have access to those visible role models through ACE. And then the tools and the resources in terms of how to get a mentor, how to prepare for your elevator pitch, dressing for success. So all of those key things that perhaps as a first gen going into professional workforce, we may not be, and we're not talking about at home. They can get that through our organization. We call it HACE or ACE. If we pronounce it in Spanish, they can be a part of that.
Fantastic. Patricia, you're really, really inspiring the important work you're doing. And I know that we're going to continue to follow your amazing, amazing efforts at the Hispanic Alliance for Career Enhancement over the next, I know, many, many years for sure. And Patricia, one of the best ways that I know that we can support your important work and learn more is certainly finding out about this upcoming celebration. But you've got a lot of information on your website. What's the best way to get in touch?
Yes, if you go to haceonline.org, you can find more information. There's also, and I know we mentioned this event, but it's our big fundraiser for the year. And part of that fundraiser is we do give away scholarships to students throughout the nation, both undergrad, grad students. We're awarding 20 scholarships this year. And so whether you can join us in person or join us virtually, or you're not able to join us but want to consider making that donation, whatever amount counts to help us with our mission, that's always greatly appreciated. And again, the website is haceonline.org.
Congratulations on your important work. I know everybody will find your leadership programs fascinating. All of your important resources. And again, I look forward to bringing you back on real soon. Patricia Mota from the Hispanic Alliance for Career Enhancement. Thanks so much for joining us again on the program. I look forward to having you back on real soon.
Thanks, Shalom.
Of course. And that's a wrap for us here on the show, all about small business jobs and entrepreneurship. You can always get in touch with me through my website, shalomklein.com. Again, subscribe, rate, review, and share on your favorite podcast app. Be sure to support our sponsors, Tom Marabali from Health Insurance, healthplanchicago.com. To success, let's get down to business.